Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to use bookmarks in Microsoft Word. In Word, bookmarks can be used as standard placeholders. However, they can also be used to create links from one part of the document to another. First, we'll create a bookmark. Then, we'll view the bookmark symbol in the text. Next, we'll move to or jump to the bookmark. We'll also create links from other places in the document to the bookmark. Finally, we'll delete the bookmark and associated links. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to the recent single purchase versions of the software. We'll cover this topic in Word for Mac in a separate tutorial, which will be linked below upon publication. To begin, place your cursor in front of the text that you want to bookmark, or select the object, such as an image, table, or chart that you want to bookmark. Next, select the Insert tab, and then select Bookmark. When the Bookmark dialog box appears, enter a name without spaces or symbols into the text box. Although you can't use spaces, you can use underscores if you need to separate multiple words, such as product description. When you're finished, select the Add button. By default, the bookmark you just created will be invisible. However, you can view the bookmark symbol by selecting the File tab, followed by More in the Backstage view, and Options from the submenu. When the Word Options dialog box appears, select the Advanced tab, and then scroll down to the Show Document Content section. From there, you can select Show Bookmarks, and then select the OK button. Your bookmark should now appear as a large I-beam next to the text. If you bookmarked an object, that object should be enclosed in two brackets instead. Now we're going to look at two ways to move to or jump to a bookmark you've saved in your document. Note that bookmarks don't appear in the navigation pane. To use the first method, select the Insert tab, followed by Bookmark. When the Bookmark dialog box appears, select the bookmark that you want, and then select the Go To button, followed by the Close button. To use the second method, select the Home tab, and then select the Find menu arrow. From there, select Go To from the drop-down menu. Next, select Bookmark in the Go To What menu in the Find and Replace dialog box, and then select the bookmark that you want in the Enter Bookmark Name menu. Lastly, select the Go To button, followed by the Close button. Before we move on, note that you can also use the keyboard shortcut Control plus G to directly open the Go To tab in the Find and Replace dialog box. Once you've created your bookmark, you can create links, also called hyperlinks, from other places in the document to that bookmark. To begin, select and then right-click the text or image where you want to insert the link. Next, select Link from the shortcut menu. When the Insert Hyperlink dialog box appears, select Place in this document, and then select the bookmark in the Select a Place in this Document menu. If you want to add a screen tip, which is a short description that appears when the reader hovers their pointer over a link, select the Screen Tip button, and then enter the description into the text box in the Screen Tip dialog box, and then select the OK button, followed by the OK button in the Insert Hyperlink dialog box. The link should now be connected to the bookmark. To test it, press the Control key on your keyboard while clicking the link to move to the bookmark. If you want to delete a bookmark later on, select the Insert tab, and once again select Bookmark in the Links group. Next, select the bookmark in the Bookmark dialog box, followed by the Delete button and the Close button. To delete a link to the bookmark, right-click the link and then select Remove Hyperlink from the shortcut menu. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at erinwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlist, How to Use Microsoft Word, where you'll find many related tutorials, including how to change the style of hyperlinks in Microsoft Word. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.